Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to use Photoshop's Puppet Warp feature that allows you to manipulate and warp a shape quickly and easily. Open a photo you'd like to use. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. I've prepped the image by cutting out the figure over the background. I did this using the Quick Selection tool and then Content Aware Fill to replace the background pixels. I've done in-depth tutorials on these techniques, so I won't be going over them here. With the figure selected, go to Edit and Puppet Warp. I'll click Show Mesh to show you how Puppet Warp analyzes the image and creates a series of interlocked triangles to create a mesh. I generally like to increase this to more points for a finer transformation. I'll decrease the expansion to 0 to make the mesh hug the shape we're going to warp. Let's click off Show Mesh so we can better see the figure under it. Now, we'll add pins to define the warp. The pins act as anchors or hinges. To illustrate this, I'll click on the neck and on the navel. When I drag from the navel, it rotates the figure from the point on the neck. I'll undo the last step by pressing Ctrl or Command Z. By clicking on the neck point to make it active and dragging it, the figure rotates from the navel. I'll undo this step as well. If you bring your cursor close to an anchor point and press and hold Alt or Option, you'll see a circle outline surrounding the point. If you rotate the circle, your shape will also rotate centered around that anchor point. You can also prevent part of your shape from moving when you rotate or drag another area. In this example, if I don't want his head to move as I rotate the arm, I'll undo the last step and click on the top of his head to anchor it. Now, when I click on the shoulder point to make it active and rotate it, his head doesn't move. I'll make an anchor point on the inside of the arm and rotate it. I'll bring the other arm around to show you another feature of Puppet Warp. Right now, the right wrist is over the left wrist. If I want the other wrist to be in front, I'll click on this icon, which will set the active pin back or behind the other wrist. The other icon sets the pin forward or in front. To accept the warp, click this check mark or press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!